नमस्ते दोस्तों, फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी हैव गैदर्ड टू कंटिन्यू व्हाट वी डिस्कस इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो व्हेन वी डिस्कस दैट व्हाट इज द रेलेवेंस ऑफ वर्ड बिजनेस इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ सप्लाई. व्हेन वी से सप्लाई, सेक्शन 7 अप्लाइज एंड सप्लाई हैज टू हैव थ्री बेसिक एलिमेंट्स दैट एनी एक्टिविटी शुड बी डन बाय अ पर्सन in the business and for a consideration. In the last video we discussed the word business, and in this video we will be discussing about consideration and person. If all these three elements are put together, the activity shall be considered as a supply. It has to be a taxable supply unless it is exempt under section 11 of the CGST Act. Now let's talk about the word consideration, which is defined under section 2 subsection 31 of the CGST Act. The definition is inclusive definition. It starts with consideration includes any payment made or to be made. It means consideration may be present, consideration may be future, whether in money or in otherwise, consideration may be in money terms, consideration may be in kind also, in respect of or in response to or for the inducement of any supply of goods and services. Whether in respect of or in response to or for the inducement, for the motivation of doing supply, shall anything done, whether in money or otherwise, shall be supply a consideration. Whether it is flowing from the recipient or any other third person also, whether it is directly paid by the recipient, directly done by the recipient or by any other person also, still shall be considered as consideration, but it shall not include any subsidy given by the central government or state government. For example, for a particular supply of goods and services, state government says that we will be giving you subsidy of 30% of the value of the goods, then that value of that 30% shall not be considered as consideration and will not form part of consideration. Second lib of the definition is the consideration includes the monetary value of any act or forbearance. Any act doing so or forbearance or not doing so in respect of, in response to or for the inducement of supply of goods and services, whether by the recipient or any other person, but shall not include the subsidy given by the central government or the state government. In this definition, a proviso is also added which says that if a deposit is given which is not being appropriated, deposit shall not be considered as consideration for the supply of goods and services unless it applies to the price of the value of the supply of goods and services. The moment it is appropriated to the price or value of the goods and services, it shall be supply, it shall be consideration. Unless there is only a deposit not applied to the price, will not form part of the consideration. Next definition is person. Section 2 subsection 84 defines word person. It again starts with includes. Person includes nine categories of persons. Start with individual, HUF, company, LLP, firm, partnership firm, AOP, BOI, any corporation established under any state act or central act, any body corporate, any cooperative society registered under the Cooperative Societies Act. All these nine shall form part of person, and if any activity is done by any of these nine in the business for a consideration, shall be supply unless it is exempted under section 11 by way of notification 12/17 central tax rate, shall be considered a taxable supply. My dear friends, we have tried to give you the broader guideline to how to determine whether a particular activity is a supply or not. By and large, every activity is a supply, taxable supply, unless it is not specifically exempted. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please do subscribe and like our channel so that we are motivated enough to continue doing this work. Thank you very much, friends.